You guys ready for your next comic? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Jay Mandium.
Guys, give it to Bob one more time. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate this. I always used to tell my dad I want to be an actor, and he would tell me it's pronounced doctor. So here I am, guys. I'm just living out my dreams, man. I grew up in Dallas, Texas. I went to a predominantly black school in Dallas. All my black friends had never seen an Indian before. They just thought I was some new kind of Mexican. And they finally believed I wasn't Mexican when I showed them how to pick a car lock by calling AAA. My parents, they don't really understand love in their family because they did this thing called an arranged marriage, which is basically a business agreement, and they don't believe that you fall in love with someone. They think that you learn to love that person, which sounds like a hostage situation to me. I don't think that's love. I'm pretty sure that's Stockholm Syndrome. But like, they don't understand love. They don't understand love between a man and a woman. They don't understand gay marriage. My dad will say things like, if a gay person gets married, that makes a mockery of my marriage. Really, Dad? Because I kind of want to say it's the 3 microwaves that your family traded for Mom. That makes the mockery of your marriage here. And like, I don't know how to talk to girls because my dad never taught me how to talk to a girl. I wanted to make a girl my Valentine once, and my dad said, "Oh, I've got a Valentine for you. Roses are red, violets are blue. You've got an arranged marriage waiting for you." Oh! Because my dad's the Indian Dice Clay, apparently. So we can just call him Dice Clay Oven. Like, I don't know how to talk to girls. I'm not good at it. And I've got friends who can do it with no problem. Like, my friend Jamar will just hit on anything that moves. We saw a pregnant girl once, and he went up to her and said, "Excuse me, miss, do you need a daddy for that baby?" I can't do that. I told a girl I work with once that she had pretty eyes, and she filed a sexual harassment complaint against me. It's not like I went up to her and said, "You have pretty eyes. Can I have them?" Jamar takes these girls because last night he bought me dinner using his food stamps and I pay my taxes, so I wasn't sure if he treated me or if I treated him. Like, the only girls that seem to be into me now are white girls on the whole Indian bandwagon. White girls on the whole hippie, yoga, vegan, life of pie, Beatles, Hindu trend. Black people have wiggers, we have windows. And I'm not blaming Gwen Stefani from the band No Doubt for all of it. But now whenever I see a white girl with a red dot on her forehead, I think, you'd better have a rifle aimed at you. Cause I grew up in Texas. I didn't get to be Indian in Texas. My nickname was Choo-choo. So if I had to be ashamed of it, you don't get to celebrate it. And I don't even know why anyone would want to be more Indian anyways. Cause like, people in India are trying to be more like us. They wear Banana Republic, but that's cause they have a you make it, you buy it policy. I've realized that one thing girls don't like about me is this. I shaved 4 hours ago and it's already back. And I get when I have facial hair like this, I look like a terrorist. Like, I get it. I got a boss who won't let me forget it. You know, she calls me names like Bin Laden and Gaddafi. And every once in a while, I just wish she would mix up the terrorist, you know. Call me like a Tim McVeigh or Citibank. Guys, I'm Jay Mandium. Thank you very much. Bring Bob back up here.